Hello everyone and welcome to the first video in Make a Game, a short series where I'm gonna cover the basics of making a video game, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. So this is for you who thought, I wanna make a game, I've got a cool idea, I wanna get into the business, it sounds cool, anything like that. You don't need any knowledge to begin out with on the matter, so we'll cover everything. And it's going to be a lot of fun, so let's get started. In this video, I'll just explain what tool we are going to be using and why, and then I'll move on to showing you where you can get it, and we'll also be starting up a project and just getting the basic elements in there. So just really, really the basics of everything. Cool, so first off, we are going to be using Unity 3D, or it's not really called 3D, but Unity. And the reason why is that it's very well known, so you're going to be able to find lots of documentation on how to do several things. It's also very beginner friendly, and still a lot of experts and professionals use it because it's fast and it can create really powerful things in a very short amount of time. So it's really the engine of fun. If you still want to do a lot and maybe even do some scripting, Unity is really, really great, and a lot of it can be achieved using visual stuff. Cool, so let's go to unity3d.com, then head under the download section, hit download. Okay, so now we can just go ahead and hit download Unity 4.2. It might have changed since this video. And we are going to be using the free version of Unity, which is still really powerful. But there's also a pro version with the black skin here, which has more advanced features. But for beginners and even intermediate users, most likely that's not something you're going to need that bad. So hit the download Unity 4.2 and it will download. I already have it installed, so let's just close this. And I've opened up Unity already. And this is just a quick preview of what kind of game we are going to be making. It's a ball rolling game. And if we just hit play here, we can see that I can roll the ball to each side and the camera will follow. And I can jump. And that's the basics of what we are going to be making. In the next few tutorials, we might expand onto that. We're definitely going to create some more interesting level design. This is really boring, but that's really the basics of the game. Okay, so go up to File, hit New Project, and you might be prompted to do this when opening Unity. Then we can select the project location. I'm going to do Browse here, and then go into Dropbox. I like to store everything in Dropbox so I can keep a backup of my project. Then make a new folder and call this Make a Game. Select that. And now we get to select what packages we want to include. These are the default packages. These contain stuff like a first-person controller for first-person games, which you can just import into the game and it will work already without any scripting. So these are just packages Unity made for us, which we don't have to make on our own. I have a little more than usual, but that's because I've downloaded some extra from the Unity Asset Store. Okay, so right now we are fine with what we have. We might use the physics materials in a future tutorial along with stuff like skyboxes, but we can always import these later. I like to keep the project clean and tight. Now let's hit create. Now Unity is going to load up all of the files running in the background, and this is how it should look. We can see that there are a bunch of different windows. I'm just going to go over them quickly as I don't want this to get too boring. First off, we have the scene view. This is where we can see all objects and navigate around. To navigate around the scene view, I use the Alt button. This is really going to do all navigation for you. So if you hold down Alt, we can click and drag, and we can pan around stuff. If we use Alt and Shift, or Alt and Control, sorry, we can drag. And if we use the zoom scroll wheel, we can zoom in on things. If you find that you get lost in the scene view, we can go up to the right hand side and click the center of the cube. This will change from perspective to ISO and so on. If you are not familiar with camera technology, you can just ignore this. Then we have the different axes, which we can click to quickly snap to side views, front views, and so on. Cool. Over here on the left-hand side, we have the hierarchy. This is all. This shows all of the objects in our scene. Right now, we only have the main camera, and that's just drawing a blue color. Then we have the game view, and this is where we want to be when we are testing out our game. Then we have the inspector, which shows all of the different things you can change once you have something selected in the hierarchy or the project pane. So that's basically the settings tab. Then we have fail to load, which we are just going to ignore. Then we have the project pane. And in here, we are going to see all of the different things in our project, which we can choose to have inside of this particular scene. Scenes are like levels. So this stores data for all the levels, and this is for this particular level. Then we have stuff like the console, where you can see error messages if you have made mistakes in scripts, and the animator, which we are going to ignore for now. Cool. You can also switch between different kinds of tools over here in the left-hand side. To get this grid showing, you can click on this landscape and disable it and enable it. Once this is enabled, the grid will disappear. Cool. Now let's actually get started creating an object. So let's go to game object, create other, and then let's choose the cube. We can see over here in the right hand side on the transform that our cube currently has a position of 3.9 on the X, 0.1 on the Y, and 5.6 on the Z. We want to just zero out this transform. So simply type 0, 0, and 0 in those three fields. We can also hit F while hovering over the scene view to focus on our cube. This is handy for quickly finding items because we can just select them in our hierarchy and then hit F to focus on them. Now that the position of our cube is centered, we should be able to see it in the game view. It's very boring at the moment, since it's just a square, and also it doesn't have any light applied to it. Let's change the scale of this to make it more exciting, and then apply lights. So if we go back to the scene view, we can change the scale to 10 on the X, 1 on the Y, and 1 on the Z. We're going to look at it from the side, so we don't really want too much going on the Z-axis, the blue one, and the Y is fine with 1. Now we can add a sphere, which is going to be our main character, our ball. So go to Game Object, Create Other, select Sphere. Now let's zero out the position X, Y, and Z, and then just drag it up to rest on top of the cube. Give it a little more than necessary, so we are sure it won't drop through. Now that we have this set up, let's rename the objects to stay organized. So go over in the hierarchy, right click on the objects and hit rename, or select them and go to the inspector over here by this checkbox. The checkbox is where we can disable and enable objects. Now let's type out a name. We're going to call this ball. You can call it whatever you want. Make sure that you notice that Unity is cap sensitive, so that you don't leave spaces all around, and that you are consistent with when you put a capital letter and a small letter. Now select the cube, hit rename for that also. Let's call this ground. Then our main camera, we can also rename this. Oops, wrong one. The main camera, I'm just gonna do main camera, but without the space. Now that we have this set up, we can go ahead and play our game. But nothing will happen. So that's not that exciting still. So let's add a light, so we can finally see what's going on. This looks all very two-dimensional. So go to Game Object, Create Other, Point Light. There are many different types of lights. Point lights emit from one single point in space out to this radius, also called the range. It has different properties like color and intensity, which you can feel free to mess around with. Shadows are not going to work unless you have the Pro version. They only work for directional lights, and they only work in hard shadows. But that's fine to play around with. So let's just move this to make it look a little better. So first let's center it to make sure we know where it is in space. Then let's drag it up and a bit out towards the camera so we can see more what's going on. You can also drag on these dots to adjust the range. It's a good idea to keep it soft and nice looking, like this. Now that we have that, we can also rename that. So let's call this light 01. We're probably going to have many lights in our scene before we're done. So this was the basics of Unity 3D. We're also going to talk about what is a component, what's a game object, and of course do some simple scripting to get our ball moving and falling. We're also going to expand on the level design and maybe even do something with coins or pickups or something. So collectible objects are always fun. Stay tuned for future videos, and I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next video.